Hello, I'm Colin Daly of Campbell Scientific in Logan, Utah. In this video tutorial, we'll connect to our CR6 over Wi-Fi. I'll be using my cell phone with a LoggerNet app, then I'll use my laptop computer. The CR6 Wi-Fi setup is the same regardless of the device you are using, a mobile device or a computer. We'll go through three basic scenarios. First, we'll connect right out of the box, no changes to settings required, super easy. Then we'll make some security modifications. And finally, we'll connect through an existing Wi-Fi network. Make sure your CR6 is powered by a 12-volt power supply. Notice that the Wi-Fi indicator is flashing green. That means it has successfully created or joined a network. It flashes more often with activity. If it flashes red, that means it can't connect to an existing network. You'll see a solid red light when it tries to join or create a network. If the LED is off completely, that means the Wi-Fi feature has been disabled. On my cell phone, we'll go to its Wi-Fi settings. Right out of the box, we can connect over Wi-Fi. Here you can see the CR6. By default, it is named CR6 underscore its serial number. Connect to that network. Here we see that the phone is connected to the CR6. Now let's go to the LoggerNet app. We have another video tutorial that covers the features of LoggerNet. Read through the Getting Started help, then tap the plus. Search by tapping the magnifying glass. It doesn't take long to find our CR6, and it is automatically added to our list of data loggers. Here you can give it a meaningful name, something like a site identifier. Tap to save. Now you can use LoggerNet to manage your CR6. Send a program, collect data, whatever else you need to do. It's that easy. Next, we'll customize our network just a bit by setting a name and password. We need to connect our computer to the CR6 using the supplied USB cable. I've already installed the USB drivers. Launch the device configuration utility. Here, I'm using LoggerNet. Make sure you have the latest version of device configuration utility installed. It needs to be version 2.11 or later. Select a CR6 from the data loggers category. I've already installed the USB drivers. If you haven't, you'll need to do that now. We have another video tutorial to walk you through those steps if needed. Choose your communications port and connect. Select OK to avoid conflicts with the server. You'll see a Wi-Fi tab. As we saw in the first scenario, the default configuration is Create a Network. Here you can name your network. A site identifier works well. Choose a password. It needs to be at least 8 characters long. You'll need to remember this when connecting your cell phone or computer over Wi-Fi. Click this ... button to see the other networks in the area. Make sure your network name, or SSID, is not already in use. Apply your settings. We're done with the device configuration utility for this scenario. Let's take a look at my cell phone again. Again, we need to go to its Wi-Fi settings. Here's my CR6 with the name we assigned a few minutes ago in the device configuration utility. Enter the password and connect. I can see that it is indeed connected. Going back to our LoggerNet app, tap the plus and search. There it is, and you can edit its settings such as the name. Tap save. It's that easy to connect now. Finally, we'll have the CR6 join an existing Wi-Fi network. Typically, this is done through an access point, and this is where the issue of firewalls come into consideration. You may need to get your IT department involved. We need to connect our computer to the CR6 using the supplied USB cable. I've already installed the USB drivers. Launch the device configuration utility. Make sure the drivers are installed and connect. Select the Wi-Fi tab. For this scenario, select Join a Network. To see which networks are available, click the ... button and choose which network to join. I'll select our CSI guest network. Yours will be something different. We need to know the password for that network and enter it. If connecting to that network requires additional security, you enter the required information here. Apply the settings. We're going to need the IP address that the Wi-Fi network assigned to our CR6. Depending on the network you're joining, it shouldn't take too long. Simply connect to the CR6 again. Go to the Wi-Fi tab. Both IPv4 and V6 notations are provided. Copy that address or write it down. And disconnect again. This time, we'll connect to our CR6 with a computer running LoggerNet. Again, you may need to get your IT department involved. First, we need to make sure our computer is on the same network as the CR6. On my computer, I access that through the network settings. The Wi-Fi on my computer needs to be enabled first. The Wi-Fi networks in the area are listed. I'll select CSI Guests because that is the network my CR6 joined, and connect. Now that our computer and CR6 are on the same network, we can set up LoggerNet to connect. From the main category, select Setup. Data loggers already in your network will be listed here. I don't have any. I'm going to use the easy setup view to add my CR6 Wi-Fi to my network. Our Quick Start video series has more information on setting up a data logger station. Choose a CR6 from the list. Give it a meaningful name. Choose IP port. And this is where you'll enter the IP address of the CR6. We copied it from the device configuration utility earlier. Our CR6 still has its default settings. If those have been changed, enter settings to match here. Test communications to make sure LoggerNet can connect to the CR6 over Wi-Fi. Our test succeeded, so we can set a clock, send a program, and do anything else we need to do. Click Finish. The CR6 Wi-Fi will create a Wi-Fi network right out of the box. You don't have to make any changes to connect directly using LoggerLink, PC400, or LoggerNet. The other option we looked at was setting up the CR6 Wi-Fi to join an existing Wi-Fi network. Make sure both devices are on the same network and you have correct passwords. Please contact a Campbell Scientific application engineer to discuss your application and for answers about getting started with your data logger and software.